Hi folks, I'm going to show you the wrong way to do your accounting in QuickBooks Online. Now you may be asking yourself, why are you showing us the wrong way to do it? Well, the thing is, I've seen many, many people do it this way. And if you find yourself doing the same thing I'm doing in this video, then you know it's really, really wrong. And I will explain why it's wrong after I do it. So the premise is that most people, when they set up QuickBooks Online, they will go ahead and connect the bank over to QuickBooks. I'm going to skip the whole connection setup portion. I will put a link in the description below where I'll explain bank feeds and connection in detail. But let's say, for example, I'm a QuickBooks user. I don't know anything about accounting. I have my banks connected. I have my credit cards connected. I'm looking at them downloaded. Notice that it downloaded 1,500 transactions from the bank, downloaded 656 from this credit card, 885 from that credit card. Now, again, I'll put a link to a video where I explain the right way to categorize all these things, but I'm going to show you what a lot of people do, or they get tempted to do when they look at this. So for example, let's say on this credit card, and I'm going to focus solely on last month. So I'm going to go here where it says all dates, and I'm going to select the dropdown and just click on last month and then click on apply. And the reason why I'm going to focus just on 1 month is just make it easier for you to sort of read and see the results. I'm also going to duplicate the tab up here in the top, and I'm going to run a report for last month. Now, this video was recorded in September, so I'm going to run a report for last month, which would be August. So I'm going to click on profit and loss, and then I'm going to run here on the drop-down menu. Let's do last month and click on run. So now you're looking at the report right there on the screen. There's absolutely no activity, no transactions for the month of August 2020, which is last month based on when I'm recording this video. So what I'm going to go back into bank transactions, and I'm going to do this wrong thing that a lot of people do. So for example, they have the transactions downloaded from the bank. They ran the filter through last month, and now it's showing a whole bunch of transactions, 17 to be exact, that were charged through the credit card that we connected to QuickBooks. Now, a lot of people would do is they'll look at this, they'll look at the description and say, yeah, that's the vendor that I purchased that through. They will completely ignore the fact that Payee is blank. To me, that's one of my big pet peeves, is when people don't put the name, the Payee name in there. And then they look at the category or match, and they say, you know what, that category sounds about right. QuickBooks is suggesting this. If QuickBooks is suggesting it, therefore it must be accurate. And people just get lazy and literally just click add and don't do what they're supposed to do, which is literally click on Payee, click on the drop-down menu, select Apple from your list, or create your vendor Apple, look at the receipt, think about the transaction, and choose the right category based on the context that represents that particular expenditure. That's the correct way to do it. And again, I have a video that shows that in depth. Instead, people will just click on add, or worse yet, they'll click on select all up here and say, you know what? Thank you, QuickBooks. You categorized everything for me. Beautiful. And just click on accept. Okay. If it was this easy, where you can literally just accept what QuickBooks is suggesting, accountants wouldn't have a career. Now I'm going to click on the other bank account. It's a completely different credit card, actually. I do the same thing. Click on the drop down, click on last month. Within the same theme per se, I'm going to ignore the details of this. I'm not going to create the vendors, which is wrong. I'm not going to look at every receipt, every category. I'm just going to click on select all, and again, accept all the transactions, because I'm trusting the categories that QuickBooks is giving me. So far, so good. Things seem to be working really well. There's an error here. We'll ignore that for now. Let's look at the bank. And the same thing, we'll filter to last month and then click on select all and then click on accept and accept whatever QuickBooks is suggesting. Now, anytime QuickBooks suggests things like undeposited funds, accounts payable, or accounts receivable, which randomly QuickBooks suggests sometimes for some crazy reason, it won't let you go through, because those account types are just not acceptable to be entered through the bank feed if you're not entering details. So let's just leave that. Of course, we are recognizing that QuickBooks didn't magically recognize everything, but it did recognize quite a bit. And the way I'll prove it to you is I'll switch over to the tab here and then click on refresh. This is my profit and loss for the month of August after I just magically clicked on accept and add all. And notice that now I have information. Now QuickBooks went ahead and looked at my chart of accounts, looked at the expense category and chose these categories for me. So again, in some cases, this could be right. I'm actually going to click on office supplies here, click on the number and just do a quick audit. So as I go through it, we got some Apple.com, Best Buy, Intuit QuickBooks, something from PayPal, QuickBooks Online monthly subscription, Audible. So Warby Parker, which are glasses, nothing to do with office supplies. They're lenses. So again, it maybe hit some of them, maybe it didn't. Contextually, it might mean different things to different people. So that's kind of the point. Now, the other question I get with pertaining to this is, Hector, why do you care so much about entering the vendor, the payee information, if when you click on any of these, you can literally read the payee information in the description? Now, as I mentioned before, I want to see the vendor names in here in this column called name, but that requires you one by one or in the bank feeds. Again, I'll post a video about the proper use of bank feeds. You would have to have created the actual vendor into your QuickBooks database in order for QuickBooks to then automatically select it or automatically use it when downloading the transaction from the bank. And the benefit from adding the vendor, creating the payee, and seeing the vendor in the payee section instead of the memo and description section is being able to do a high level analysis to run expenses by vendor. So for example, if I go to reports and I type here vendor, notice that there's transactions like expenses by vendor summary, one of my favorite reports actually, one of my favorite reports in the world. If I do expenses by vendor summary, and I'll do this for, let's say, last month, right? Because it's the only month that I have transactions on. Notice that only the one that I actually created a vendor for and actually selected the payee in the transaction shows up, and everything else shows up under not specified. So that's a huge benefit of actually adding the payee, the vendor name, to each of the transactions. And that should have been done at the bank feeds level. So when you were actually entering the transaction in the bank feeds, and I'll just do a quick example. When you're entering the transactions in the bank feeds, and let me put something that's more recent here, sort that, then you should have gone into this transaction and go to payee and type Apple and add it to the database and create it as a vendor and add that transaction. So QuickBooks can now suggest the next Apple transactions to actually enter that vendor name. So it's not, it doesn't really take a long time to create these vendors at first. Yes, it takes a lot longer. I actually have a special trick in which we take this, export it to Excel, and then re-import it in your master vendor list. I'll put a link in the description for that specific video where I also explain kind of a shortcut or a trick to bring a lot of these payee names quicker into your database so you're not creating them one by one. So anyway, this was the wrong way of entering transactions into QuickBooks Online. Hopefully, you didn't catch yourself doing this. And if you did, you're probably going to have to hire an accountant to help you clean things up. And I know I've done a lot of work of cleaning things up for my clients. But if you are doing them wrong, then just do them correctly moving forward. I hope you like this video. If you have any comments, questions, something I lived out, put it in the description, actually in the comments. I'll try to get to those answers. And subscribe to the channel. Every time I create a video about QuickBooks accounting, taxes, you get notified and you'll learn how to manage your business better. Thank you very much, and I'll see you on the next one.